Do you like to be alone? Do you feel more alive when you're at home doing something you enjoy than when you're with others? Don't worry, you're not the only one. In fact, I'm just like you. But have you ever wondered why you enjoy alone time as much as you do? I've been wondering this about myself for a while. So to prove that I'm not weird for spending so much time alone, I started to research why this might be the case. Here are 10 personality traits and behaviors of people who like to be alone. Number 1, you're an introvert. Surprise, surprise. I'm sure you've heard of the word introvert before, or you already understand what it means. Basically, an introvert gets drained of energy when they spend time with others, whereas an extrovert gains energy. In fact, studies have suggested that introverts tend to be highly sensitive to the neurotransmitter dopamine, which fires in the brain far too often with prolonged social exposure. You also tend to find alone time as peaceful and even energizing. So you find yourself becoming easily drained of energy when you're around others. Then you might be an introvert, and this is the reason you enjoy spending time alone. Number 2, you tend to have less energy than others. We've all met them before, the type of person that seems to have an endless supply of energy. They're fun to hang out with for 30 minutes, but after that, they can get seriously annoying. Now, I'm not talking about just introvert versus extrovert here. I'm talking about basic energy supply. For you, your favorite place is a comfortable couch or chair, whereas others get energized from being active. No, this doesn't mean you're not fit or you don't exercise at all. You can still exercise. You just love taking time out and sitting on the couch. It's where you feel at peace. It's where you energize yourself, and it's where you ponder your deepest thoughts or watch TV. Whereas some people feel more energy after being active, you'd rather relax. There's nothing wrong with that. And that's why you love spending time alone. Number 3, when you're alone, you get to do what you want to do. When you're with other people, you don't always get to do what you want to do. There's always an element of compromise. You can't always pick your favorite movie or go to your favorite restaurant when there are other people involved. And sure, every now and then, it's fine to try a new restaurant that your friend recommends. But when it comes down to it, you'd rather just do what you want to do. This is why you love being alone. You don't have to compromise. You can work on your passion projects or watch your favorite TV shows. Everything is easy. Number 4, you prefer quiet time. You're at peace with your soul when you're sitting in silence. But as soon as people are around, the peace you love is gone. And it's not even the other person making noise that upsets you. It's their presence that makes you uncomfortable. It means you can't fully relax and enjoy the moment. It's only when you're alone that you can completely let go and be yourself. Number 5, you can't stand small talk. We've all been there. How are you? Great weather today. It's such a waste of time. For you, small talk is meaningless and superficial. You don't get to know someone for who they truly are. Instead, the questions and answers lack so much meaning that it doesn't need to be said. It's just a way to feel the silence. But for you, you'd rather bask in the glory of silence. If you're going to talk to someone, you'd rather get to know them at a deep level. What makes them tick? What is their life plan? You want to know their purpose behind someone's actions and what they find joyful in life. That is what really gets your juices flowing. But small talk is so common these days that you prefer spending time alone. Number 6, you do your best work alone. You are much more productive when you're alone in your office than when others are near you. This is because it's hard for you to not get distracted when other people are around you. People talking, random questions while you're working, the sounds of people chewing their food around you, it irks you to your core. And it really upsets your workflow. Perhaps this is something to do with the fact you're not as comfortable around others as extroverts are. You prefer to be alone, concentrating on what you need to get done. Number 7, you don't gossip or engage in drama. gossiping, talking about other people behind their back, one-upping people to make yourself look better, that's just not your style. In your mind, people spend way too much time on these toxic behaviors. It's just wasted energy. For you, it doesn't even make you feel good. You prefer to focus on yourself while keeping the peace with everyone else. Now, of course, you'd stand up for yourself and others if you need to, but this is different. In the end, gossiping about who did what, who insulted who, and why so-and-so is a bad person only serves to make others feel bad, and that is the last thing you want to do. Number 8, you are emotionally independent. You don't have a strong desire to be around people all the time. You also don't rely on people to give you validation and make you feel better. You are your own source of happiness. You also consider yourself a balanced person. Your highs aren't as high as other people and your lows aren't as low. You rely on yourself to deal with your own emotional problems. You don't search for outside help. This makes you feel comfortable and secure when you're spending time alone because you're not relying on anything or anyone for your own happiness. Number 9, you find it hard to deal with other people's emotional issues. Even though you're emotionally independent, you actually find helping others with their emotional struggles as quite challenging. This is most likely because you have strong empathy and you can feel the pain another person is feeling. When you're asked to help someone, it can feel like the weight of the burden falls heavily on your own shoulders as you absorb their emotions. This is why you like spending time alone, as it is the simplest way to keep your emotional balance. Number 10, you're quite content with life. You're perfectly happy with how your life's going and where you're at. You just don't need to constantly see people and arrange nights out to feel better about yourself. You accept yourself for who you are, and you're happy to spend time alone doing what you want to do. There's no FOMO, fear of missing out, when you miss social occasions because you know that you'd rather spend time home alone anyway. This makes it very easy for you to say no when someone asks you out.